This video shows how to test the normality assumption as a requirement for the repeated measures one-way ANOVA in R. First question, what has to be approximately normally distributed? It is the dependent variable for each point in time a measurement has been taken that should be normally distributed. There are three possible ways to test this. First, an analytical test like the Shapiro-Wilk-test, second, a histogram, or third, a QQ plot. The Shapiro-Wilk-test is oversensitive to unimportant deviations from normal distribution in large samples. This is a phenomenon for all analytical tests, for which you can find a source in the video description. A QQ plot is the easiest to interpret, therefore we continue creating one for each measurement. For that, we load up the ggpubr package and use its ggqq plot function. Start with your data frame, followed by the dependent variable in quotation marks, and eventually the argument facet.by equals and your time variable in quotation marks. The interpretation of the QQ plot is straightforward. The dots represent the standardized measurements and the line the perfect normal distribution. Therefore, the distances between the dots and the line should be minimized. Again, there will be acceptable deviations, especially on the edges of the distribution, meaning the upper right hand and the lower left hand corners. In my example, deviations in both of those corners can be a bit problematic. If you are in doubt, you might consider going with the Friedman test, which is the non-parametric alternative to the repeated measures one-way ANOVA, and for which I have linked a playlist to go from A to Z.